Now, let's understand what is Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation and what is the way to calculate, and then we'll do some problems on that.
We learned about scattered diagram. So this method indicates the direction of correlation, but then we don't get an exact value of magnitude. Okay, so what happened? A mathematical method of measuring the magnitude of linear relation between, let's say, two statistical series X and Y was given by the statistician Carl Pearson. Okay, so we are going to do the problems on finding out Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation. Now, there are three methods to do that. First, we are going to do is direct method. So here, I have the X and the Y value. Okay, first thing is, we have to make this table. So you can see, the first column is my X values I have listed down. Then, I will find out the small x, which is X minus X bar. So for that, we'll have to calculate the X bar. Then we will square this column and list it down. Now I will list down my Y values given to me. So all these values will be listed down here. Then I will find out the small y, which is Y minus Y bar. Square this column and list down here. And this would be X minus Y, which is this column multiplied by this column. We'll get the result. So first I have listed down here the X and the Y. Okay, and have done a summation. So you can see summation of X is 120, summation of Y is 100. So first, find out the arithmetic mean. Okay, so summation X upon N would be 120 divided by 10, because N is equal to 10. So you will get 12 and you will get Y bar as 10. Now, coming back here, we already know it is 12, X bar is 12. So X minus X bar, 10 minus 12 is minus 2. So I'll get this entire column now. So if I do a summation, it should come to 0. If it isn't 0, there's something wrong. Now let's find out the square of deviation, which is this small X square. That is 2 square 4. 0 is 0. Minus 1 square is 1. So on and so forth. If you do the summation, you will get summation of small x square equal to 24. Similarly, we'll find this out for y. Okay, now we already know y bar is equal to 10. So y minus y bar, that is 7 minus 10, is minus 3, so on and so forth. So here my summation y is equal to 0. Square of deviation would be 3 square 9, minus 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, so on and so forth. So summation of y square would be 15. I have to find out xy, which is nothing but minus 2 multiplied by minus 3 to get 6. 0 multiplied by minus 1 is 0. Minus 1 multiplied by 2 is minus 2. So again, I'll do a summation and get summation of xy, which is equal to minus 4. Okay, now let's come and find out the standard deviation of x series, which is summation of square root of summation of x square divided by n. That is what you found out here. Summation of x square was 24. Okay, so 24 divided by 10, that would be 2.4. square root of 2.4 is 1.5, which you can see here. Now summation of y series would be, standard deviation of y series would be square root of summation of y square divided by n, which is 50 divided by 10. That is square root of 5, which is 2.24. Now, Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation is found out by this formula, which is R is equal to, it is represented by R, summation of xy divided by n multiplied. Now see, for your ease, I have given this sign. We generally write this as n dot standard deviation x dot standard deviation y, which is nothing but n multiplied by standard deviation x multiplied by standard deviation y. So summation xy, we already know it is minus 4, which you can see here, divided by n, which is 10, multiplied by standard deviation x, 1.55, multiplied by 2.24. So if you total this and do the calculations, you will get minus 0.115. What does this indicate? It indicates there is a low degree of negative correlation between x and y. Now, let's come to the next problem. So, here I am going to find out Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation using the shortcut method. Now, everything would remain same in terms of making this table. Only thing is, I'll assume a mean. See, the best way to assume a mean is take a middle value. So, I've taken this value out here. Okay, you can take 30 or you can take 32, whatever you like. Okay, so we will find out dx, which is 24 minus 32, 27 minus 32, so on and so forth. Now, n I've already counted, which is equal to 11. Summation of dx is equal to minus 11. Now, I'll square this column and find out summation of dx square, which is 217. Now, similarly, I'll assume a mean for y. So, I have taken the value out here to be 25, okay, because I feel that's what the middle value would be. See, here what I have done is the lowest value is 18 and the highest value seems to be 30. Okay, so based on that, I've come to a conclusion that I'll take A as 25. You can also do one thing, you can take it as 28 if you want. So, similarly, I found out summation of dy, which is equal to minus 3. Then I'll square this column and find out the summation of square, which would be 173. And here I will multiply this column with this column, okay, to get dx dy, which is summation of dx dy, which is 98. Now, the formula to be used is n multiplied by summation of dx into dy, summation of dx multiplied by summation of dy divided by square root of summation of dx square into n minus summation of dx square multiplied by square root of summation of dy square into n minus summation of dy the whole square. So, I have substituted the values for ease. I have already reproduced this table out here. So, when you substitute the values, you will get the approximate value as 0.5. So, there is a medium degree of positive correlation between x and y series.